It won't be for long. Just long enough for them to find out what's going on.
Please don't leave me here.
Just for a couple of days. You'll see. Time will go by fast.
Susan, we need to go. There's no reason to drag this out.
Be brave, darling. You're strong. I know you're strong.
Leaving your home and your family. But here we have a better chance of understanding what's happening. We can find a way to protect you.
Nobody can protect me.
Your belongings are in that bag over there. Cole and I are right next door. If you need anything or if anything's wrong, just call and we'll come right away. Okay. Good night, Jody.
All right. Find somewhere to change. Hope they haven't put cameras in here, too. Bunnygruff, where's my rabbit?
Off to bed now, Jody. I'm gonna turn out the light now. Good night, Jody.
Wait. Can you leave the light on in the hall? I don't like it when it's dark.
Sure. How's that?
Good.
Good night.
Night. Don't be afraid, Eden. We're gonna have a good night's sleep, and nothing is gonna happen. I can't sleep, Eden. I think I need a story.
Jody! Get a doctor! Hurry!
It's okay. It'll be all right now. Hayden isn't scared of them anymore.
I said no. End of story.
Please, Nathan, just this once. All the other girls in my class are going, and I won't be late. I promise, okay?
You're wasting your breath, Jody.
It's just not fair. How come everyone can go and I can't? I do everything you ask of me all week, and I never get to have any fun.
For the 100th time, you're not like everyone else, and there are rules.
Well, I didn't ask to be different. I just want to go out and have friends and be like other girls my age.
You'll never be like them. You need to get used to that.
Good night. I'll be next door. Let me know if you need anything. Do it, babe. Rules are rules.
Please. Come on, Cole. Please. Please let me out just this once. What do you have to tell Nathan everything?
I'm sorry, Princess,
but I can't. It's not my call.
Do something, for God's sake!
Stop it, Jody! This is not gonna do you any good. Grounded, period.
Work, we have to figure out what will. Yeah, she was mad, all right, but she's calmed down now.
All right. Sure.
I'm really sorry, Cole. I hate myself for doing this, but you understand, right? I need to go out tonight. Yeah, I know. It's too late to turn back now. Locked. Of course it is.
Well, hello, Cole.
Jody.
A little late for day trip, isn't it?
Well, it was Nathan's idea. Some kind of, like, night training in the D-Wing. I mean, as if my days weren't enough for his experiments.
Funny, because, you know, I just spoke to Professor Dawkins and...
He just called my cell. And, I don't know, it's just like a sudden flash of genius or something, and so, he wants me to do this new experiment, but I don't know, really.
Well, you know them scientists, they never stop. What's up, Cole? Cat got your tongue? Hmm?
He's in a really bad mood. He hasn't even said a word all day. He lost his voice. I think it's like a virus or something. That's more than I've gotten out of him all day long. So.
It's not contagious, buddy. You should be home in bed, if you ask me. Safer for all of us. All right, well, see ya. Go on now.
Well, at least we don't have to look for Cole's car. There's cameras everywhere. Better not hang around here too long. Now get in the car and start it up. I'm not really out of sight. Let's go, Aiden. I'll try not to attract attention, okay?
Good call, my man. Night off? Jody?
Central Security now!
You'll forgive me, right? I'll be back soon. And don't worry, I'll be fine. Aiden, take him into the forest. Make sure he's safe. This is the place. The girls must be inside already. They're not here yet. We'll wait. No, we'll wait.
How old are you, miss?
I'm 21. I just want a lemonade.
I told you not to go, and you disobeyed me. You know how dangerous that was for Cole and for you? Hell, Jody, don't you remember Kirsten's birthday party? You know what can happen with Aiden, right? Right?
Sorry. Just wanted to go out and be like everyone else for once.
I know, Jody. I know.
I
I don't know how to tell you this, Jody, so I'm just gonna tell you. Your mom and I, we've been transferred. We have to leave the base. We really want to take you with us, but we think... Everyone thinks that it would be better for you to stay here with Professor Dawkins. Of course, we'll come to see you whenever it's possible. And when you're better, you'll join us in our new home. Okay? Well, I think it's for the best. Goodbye, dear.
Be brave, darling. I know this is difficult. I'm sure it'll work out.
Gotta go, Susan.
Just give me a minute, Philip.
That's enough. Come on.
Jody, we're here. We'll always be here for you.
I'm totally exhausted and thirsty, and I have no clue where we fucking are, so just play nice and give me a break, okay?
Everything's gonna be okay. I'm in the middle of nowhere. I'm dying of thirst. And everything's fucked. But it's gonna be okay. Leave me alone, Aiden. What? okay, Aiden. There's no reason to be nervous. I'm so sorry to disturb you. I'm just looking for some place to spend the night, and I was hoping that...
You can't stay here. Sorry.
Please. It's gonna be really cold tonight. No, I have nowhere else to go, and I promise I will be gone by morning.
I told you you can't stay here. You need to leave now.
Ya, ya.
Ya, esposo. Akuri nao. Dobone, zarahe. Edin ne.
Ote ye. Sotnoas, ad. Bendako, a doth kath. Ado, a bendago, no doth do.
It's okay. You can stay here tonight. Come in. What's your name?
Jody.
I'm Paul. These are my sons, Corey and Jay. My mother, Shimasani. Don't be surprised if she doesn't answer you. She hasn't spoken in years. We're about to have dinner. Would you like to eat with us?
Yeah, thank you.
We don't see many hitchhikers out here. Can I ask where you're headed?
I just keep moving from day to day. I guess if I keep going long enough, I'll figure out where I'm headed.
I see.
This is the first ranch that I've seen in miles.
There used to be more of us. Many have left for the city. It's a hard life out here.
You guys are really far from everything here.
My family's lived here for generations. I was born here. I'll probably die here. I tell my boys to go. I know there's nothing for them here. But, they want to stay with their grandmother and me, so...
You guys are, Navajo, right?
With the name.
That means the people in that world. That's what we call ourselves.
Coming?
You stay in your room, no matter what you hear.
What I hear? What do you mean?
You value your life? Lock your door and don't come out until the morning.
Ashes. What's got them so scared? It's a very strange place. Don't worry. Tomorrow will be a long way from here. Good night, Aiden. was that?
Go back to bed. You can leave in the morning.
You looked exhausted. I told the boys to let you sleep.
Thanks. I really needed it.
Made some coffee.
I'm gonna hit the road. Thank you.
There's a lot of work to be done on the farm. Maybe you'd like to stay on for a few days. Lend a helping hand. Couldn't pay you anything, but you have a roof, food on the table. What do you think?
Yeah. Yeah, why not?
You'll find some more clothes in Corey's room. See you outside.
Ready for work?
I'm ready when you are.
The sheep need water. Think you can handle that?
Sure.
So, you're gonna stay a while?
It looks that way.
Great. I mean, it's good to have some help.
Thank you.
Thanks, Judy. Can you get some hay from the barn?
Jody, and I'm gonna stay here for a little bit and help out. I hope that you don't mind. This is beautiful. Did you make this yourself? Help me, Aiden.
Take it easy, Aiden. Just one bale, not the whole goddamn haystack.
Hey, Jody! Lunch?
Okay, let me just finish this first.
Put it down anywhere. Thanks, Jody. Lunchtime. Go and join the boys if you're hungry.
You coming?
Later. I still have work to do.
Okay, later then.
Have a seat.
Thanks. Is it true that your grandmother hasn't spoken in years?
Yeah. My father said she hasn't said a word since my great-grandmother died. That's gotta be 30 years.
There's a lot of work to do on the ranch.
Yeah. Jay takes care of the horses. I watch the churros, and my father does just about everything else.
know, when I opened the door last night, I saw something. Pretty sure someone was outside.
I don't know what you're talking about. It's probably a dream.
I saw the dead sheep. What happened to them?
A storm. They wander out of the pen and choke to death on the sand. Do you always ask so many questions?
When I don't understand something, yeah.
Yeah? How about if I started asking you questions? Where you come from? What you're doing here? You probably wouldn't like it, huh? So keep your secrets to yourself. And don't ask any more questions. You'll excuse me. I got work to do.
Don't mind him, Jody. He's okay when you get to know him.
I'll bet.
Well, I guess I better get back to it or Paul will get mad. See you later.
Well done, Jody.
You need help, Corey?
No, not really.
I'm gonna go see if Jay needs any help.
Yeah, later.
Let's see what Jay's doing.
Whoa! Whoa!
Proud and stubborn. Never wants to go in with the others.
Do you mind if I try?
You worked with horses before?
No.
Go right ahead. His name's Oshki.
Hey there, Oshki. Don't be afraid. I'm just gonna come over there, okay? See, Oshki? That's not so bad, is it? Admit it. You kinda like me, huh? Hey, Aiden. Ever dreamed of riding a horse? Take him to the enclosure.
How'd you do that?
We all have our secrets, right?
Maybe I misjudged you.
If you want to take a shower, it's behind the barn. Ladies first.
It's fine by me.